Welcome to the Invite Health Podcast, where our degreed healthcare professionals are excited to offer you the most important health and wellness information you need to make informed choices about your health. You can learn more about the products discussed in each of these episodes and all that Invite Health has to offer at www.invitehealth.com/podcast. First-time customers can use promo code podcast at checkout for an additional 15% off your first purchase. Let's get started.
Did you know that over 65% of the adults in the United States take a prescription medication? That is a very high number. And out of that 65% that are on a prescribed medication, many of those people are taking more than once. We're talking pharmacotherapy at its finest. We're talking multiple medications, and we certainly see this as people get older. When the elderly, for example, we will see that on average, the median number of medications taken by adults in the United States over the age of 65 is upwards of 4 medications. And it is not uncommon to see someone on 10, 12, 15 medications per day, which is really quite scary. And the thing that I want to focus in on is what happens when someone is on these medications long term in terms of what is occurring biochemically in the body. Yes, oftentimes a prescribed medication is warranted and required and needed, but we also have to take into consideration the potential for drug-induced nutrient depletion. And this is so common. And quite interestingly enough, oftentimes doctors overlook this because their focus is never on nutrition or vitamins or minerals, but yet often the medications that they are prescribing to people are creating significant imbalances in essential vitamins and minerals and other key nutrients that the body requires in order to function properly. So we fall back and we look and say, okay, 65% at least of Americans are on at least one medication per day. What is the end result of that? And so I do want to talk about this in detail. I'll talk about some certain specific commonly prescribed medications and the common nutrients that are implicated in terms of the depletion effect. So I am Amanda Williams, MD, MPH, and let's get right to it. Let's talk about what happens when someone is on a prescribed medication and the real negative implication that that has. We know that when it comes to medications for blood pressure, for example, this is one of the most commonly class of drugs that is prescribed in this country. So whether we're looking at ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, thiazide diuretics, loop diuretics, statin medications, when it comes to cholesterol, we certainly know that those are incredibly popular in this country. But we have to understand what is happening on the other end. While those medications may be working to try to regulate the blood pressure, at the same time, they could be creating another series of havoc in the body. And so I always encourage people that if you or a friend, a family member, a coworker is on a prescribed medication, please go to our website and go and look at our drug-induced nutrient depletion chart. It is a handy, useful guide and can really make such a difference. I have talked to numerous people through the years of me doing this where they're on a beta blocker, for example, say atenolol or metoprolol for blood pressure, and they've been on it for many years. And they seem to think that I'm not having any problems with this, but yet when you start to delve into it a little bit more and they'll say, yeah, my energy's not so good, or I don't really sleep well. Well, interestingly enough, they may be completely unaware of the fact that beta blocking drugs that I have just mentioned, things like atenolol, things such as metoprolol, propranolol, can create a deficiency in things such as coenzyme Q10 in the body, which is required for cellular energy production. It can lower the body's melatonin levels, which can then be implicated in improper sleep. We also know that those beta blockers can lower your chromium, which can then potentially have an impact on your blood glucose regulation. So it's important to know these things, and to have this handy guide around can really give you a lot of insight. Because, for example, if you are on hydrochlorothiazide, which is so commonly prescribed for blood pressure, but it's also a diuretic, and oftentimes it's in a combination drug therapy. So they actually will combine like an ACE inhibitor along with the thiazide diuretic or the beta blocker with that thiazide. But while the thiazide diuretic is meant to help to regulate blood pressure and help to remove fluid from the body, at the same time, it can create deficiencies in things such as magnesium, which is so important when it comes to the regulation of blood pressure. So you're taking something to try to control your blood pressure, but at the same time, it's lowering your magnesium. And if it's lowering your magnesium, you're more prone to have greater vasoconstriction. So we have to be aware of these things. So if we are on a medication, we need to at minimum be taking these nutrients in addition to that medication. So if you're on hydrochlorothiazide, you should be taking magnesium as well. You should be looking at CoQ10, zinc, vitamin D, potassium. These are all things that we know that those thiazide diuretics, such as hydrochlorothiazide, can do to the body. So even if you're taking just a basic multivitamin, that's better than not taking anything. So you could do the core multivitamin, for example. And at least you're getting some of that coverage back from the potential loss that the drugs themselves could be driving up. And many medications deplete these critical nutrients. So we have to be aware of these potential deficiencies, and we have to be proactive to that. Except most healthcare practitioners do not look for these things. They look for the major side effects that are known with certain medications, but they don't pay any attention to the nutrients that are being depleted. And this is a major, major problem. When we even look at, and this isn't just related to people who are, 60 and older, who are on many different medications, maybe for high blood pressure and cholesterol, maybe you have diabetes. This can affect younger people too. When you look at, say, birth control medications or any type of hormone replacement that someone may be on. When a woman is prescribed a birth control or any type of a hormone, you have to be aware that those synthetic estrogens and all of those other hormones, even the bioidentical hormones, can create significant depletions of many different key nutrients in the body, including B vitamins, zinc, vitamin C, magnesium. So if you're taking a hormone replacement, or if you're on something such as a birth control pill, and you are unaware of the fact that B6 levels are becoming depleted, and B6 plays a very important role in over 130 different reactions in the body. So B6 can then drive up the potential for mood issues, because it can create low serotonin. It can screw up your melatonin levels, which can then disrupt the sleep. It can potentially elevate your homocysteine levels, which means you have greater likelihood of vascular inflammation occurring, which can also be associated, low B6 in the body can be associated with anxiety. These are all things that we need to know. I mean, magnesium, we know, is kind of this main mega nutrient in the body that plays a role in over 300 different functions in the body. And we know that there are over 100 prescribed medications that can cause magnesium depletion. So many different blood pressure medications. We certainly know certain antibiotics can do this. And if we do not have adequate magnesium, look at how many different pathways we have now screwed up. We know at this point in time that the statin medications, which people are prescribed at a very high rate in this country to try to control and regulate healthy cholesterol, deplete CoQ10, which is why many times when people are on those statin medications, they'll experience things such as muscle cramps. Well, why? Because the body can't make coenzyme Q10 in those myocytes. Those muscle cells are starved out of their ability to produce energy. So if we know these things, then we can try and do our best to cover those gaps. When we look at certain medications and we realize that a medication like a statin drug can lower your CoQ10, lower your omega-3 levels, even lower your lutein. And lutein is very important for our eye health. So think about that. Think about the long-term use of something that's targeted towards maintaining cholesterol, but could be impacting your vision and potentially making you at a greater risk for age-related macular degeneration. But yet your doctor will never correlate the two. They just don't think that way. I mean, how many people are on corticosteroids? So we're talking about things for asthma, allergic rhinitis, people who are on these strong medications on a daily basis to keep their airways open, but yet are unaware that that corticosteroid is lowering things like B vitamins once again, vitamin C, vitamin D, which we know vitamin D is critical for our immunity. All of these nutrients are critical for both our innate and adaptive immune system response. So if we're taking a corticosteroid to try and make sure our airways stay open, for example, but yet we're lowering our magnesium and our selenium and our zinc and our melatonin, and we wonder, why am I still prone to getting sick? Well, it makes a lot of sense because the medication that we're taking is kind of wiping out our main drivers, the main factors for our immune system. So we look at all of these different nutrients that have that potential for being depleted, like calcium channel blockers. This is another very commonly prescribed class of medications. We look at the drug amlodipine, which also goes by the trade name of Norvasc. And we know that this is targeted for high blood pressure, but at the same time, it can lower your vitamin D level. So people need to be aware of this. If you were on a calcium channel blocker, you at minimum should be having your vitamin D level tested once a year because you may need additional vitamin D. And then when we look at the medications, for example, when it comes to diabetes, how many diabetics are in this country who are taking things such as metformin, which we know can lower your B12 level? Every single diabetic who is prescribed metformin should also in conjunction be prescribed vitamin B12, but yet they are not. So if I sound a little irritated in this, it's because I am, because I see what happens to folks who are on these medications long term and then the lingering damaging effects that can so easily be mitigated if they just do the right thing from the beginning. And it's not the fault of the person who's on the medication, because how are they to know? But that's why I'm talking about it today. And I'm telling you about this handy little list that we have that can help you identify, okay, this is the drug that I'm on. Let's look and see what nutrients potentially are going to get depleted because I'm on this. And if I know this, then I can do my part by taking and getting that coverage. And all of this can make a huge difference in how you feel. And at the end of the day, this is what's important. And just think about some over-the-counter things. Many times people are not even aware of the fact that NSAIDs, for example, the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications that people take like they're candy in this country, can lower your folic acid levels, which can affect so many aspects of our health. It affects our normal detoxification pathways, for example. Aspirin, we know, can impact your folic acid levels, your vitamin C, your zinc levels. You look at acetaminophen. We know CoQ10 levels and glutathione levels take a hit when someone is taking acetaminophen on a regular basis. Then you look at people who are popping their, you know, antacids on a regular basis for their acid reflux and heartburn, who are unaware that that antacid is creating a deficiency in vitamin D and chromium and iron and zinc and beta carotene. People who are on prescribed medications for acid reflux are not aware that those medications create deficiencies, once again, in B vitamins that are required for proper detoxification of the body. And iron and zinc, once again. So the more we know about these medications, the more that we realize that, okay, maybe I have to be on this drug because I have a certain condition and doesn't matter what I've tried, I require an actual medication. But you have to also be aware that that medication, while it's helping on one hand, can be hurting on the other. So go to our website and look at our drug-induced nutrient depletion chart, or you can contact any of our stores. All of the stores have copies of the drug-induced nutrient depletion chart. And it is so incredibly advantageous to know these things, because what we do know is that 65%, if not more, of Americans are on at least one medication, most of those being on four medications or more. So we have to be proactive in this. So encourage you to spread the word, tell friends and family members to be aware that the medication that they are on may be creating a depletion of key nutrients that the body needs to function properly. So that is all that I have for you for today. I want to thank you so much for tuning in to the Invite Health Podcast. Remember, you can find all of our episodes for free wherever you listen to podcasts or by visiting invitehealth.com/podcast. Now do make sure that you subscribe and you leave us a review. You can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Invite Health. And we will see you next time for another episode of the Invite Health Podcast.